Hi, everyone. All right, we'll get started. And I was trying to think of something new that we could do today. And one of the poses that came into mind was called Camel Pose. And Camel Pose is a kind of like a back bend. And it's called Camel Pose because once we're in it, you might feel like with your chest open and your spine is bent, you might be kind of like a shape, like one of the humps on a camel's back. So to do that, and just like we normally do, I don't want to get into this pose before stretching. So we want to make sure that we're stretching and we're warmed up and we're ready to go. So since that pose is a lot of a back bend or stretching the spine is what goes up from your neck all the way down to your lower back. So I want to work on some poses, some stretches that will help loosen up our spine a little, so when we go into camel pose, our bodies will be ready. So to do that, we're going to start in tabletop. So I'm gonna come on the rug over here. I don't have my mat out today, and I don't think I really need it. So I'm gonna come to the rug, and I'm gonna get into tabletop. So if you remember tabletop, you're going to have your hands on the ground, and your fingers are spread here, and I have my wrists aligned with my shoulders, and my knees are slightly apart, and they're aligned with my hips here. So this is our tabletop. And remember, it's called tabletop because we're making the shape of a table. So as if a vase or something could sit on your back, on your spine, and it would be nice and straight. So we're having a nice straight spine here. All right, so from here, we're gonna do some cat and cows. And if you remember cat and cows, the shapes move like the animal. A cow has a back that drops low like this, and a cat pose is called cat because when you're in it, it looks like a cat that stretches when they're maybe waking up from a nap. So we're gonna move through some of these. So we'll start with cow. So cow, we're dropping the belly and we're lifting the shoulders and the head up and the hips are coming up. And then we're gonna come back to cat. So remember cat, lifting that spine up, and then you can let the head drop here. So we're gonna move through some of these. See if you can move from cow to cat and just keep going. So we're loosening the spine here. So we're doing lots of movements just for the spine. And if you want to add your breath here, when you open the chest up in your cow, you're taking a breath in. And when you're moving through your cat, you're taking a breath out. So you're breathing out, breathing in, breathing out, breathing in. One more round, breathing out, breathing in, cow. And then let's come back to tabletop so that spine is nice and neutral here. So those are one of the movements you can do to start stretching your spine out. So cat and cow. Cow has the dip and the cat's back is arched like it's stretching. And the next pose that we can do to help loosen up our spine a little more is a bridge pose. So I'm gonna come back here and I'm gonna lie down on my back with my knees coming up and my feet planted on the ground. All right, so bridge, I think we've done this one before too. So I'm lying down on my back and my knees are coming up and my feet are planted on the ground here. So to make it a bridge, and it's called bridge because once you come up, you might look like a bridge that you would drive over. So I'm gonna keep my hands on the ground, and then I'm gonna press really hard against my feet and my upper back to see if I can lift my hips up towards the sky. And you can do that and keep your hands on the ground here and keep that gaze coming up, pressing your hips up so they're trying to reach up really high, and you're breathing. And you can stay just like this, or if you like to change the grip, you can start to bring your shoulders closer together and then clasp the hands behind your back. So my hands are coming together, my fingers are interlacing, and I'm pressing up nice and high. Big deep breaths here. And remember, if you can, breathing in and out of your nose.
And when you're ready, we'll come back down, releasing the hands. Okay. And we'll do that one more time. So when you're ready, hands on the ground, pressing the hips up, really pressing against the feet nice and firmly, interlacing the hands, the fingers if you did, and trying to keep pressing up while keeping your breath, breathing in and out. If you want to add a little more, you can try to see if you can lift a leg up while keeping your bridge. This is tricky. And then when you're ready, putting it back down, and we'll switch legs. So lift the other leg up. And bring it back down. And then release and come right back to the ground. And then from here, let's windshield wiper the legs. So you bring the feet out a little farther away. I'm going to drop the knees from one side up and coming over to the other, like the windshield wipers in a car, so you can move them slow. Or if you want the windshield wipers to move faster, you can move them a little bit faster here, dropping knees one side and the other. Okay. All right, I'm gonna come back up here. So that was our bridge pose. And I'm going to show you a picture of camel pose. So you can see what it will look like once we're there. Okay, so this is camel pose. So she's doing a back bend. So her spine right here, it's tilted back, just like when we were doing our bridge and our cat and cows. And her hands are coming towards her feet. So I'll show you back here how to get into it. So to start and to get into camel, you're gonna start sitting on your knees here. Like when we do lion's breath, you're sitting down, knees coming forward, and you're sitting on your ankles. And from here, I'm gonna come up on my hips, and my hands can come right to my hips here. So I'm sitting up nice and tall on my knees, and my feet are not together. They're spread a little bit apart. And we'll do this one hand at a time. And you're gonna you wanna make sure you're pressing your hips away from the body here, so you don't want them to be in. You want your hips sticking out like our bridge. From here, I'm gonna take one hand, and my thumb is coming up towards the sky. You wanna reach it up, and just let my hips come forward, and then I'll come back down. All right, we'll do the other side. So we're gonna come up on the hips, other hands coming up and pressing the hips away, reaching back, and then come back down. Okay, so we're gonna come up again, and this time, you can start to bring the hand out and away, and if you can, using that hand to see if you can grab the ankle or the foot. So I have one hand on my ankle and my thumb is facing out and I can reach the other hand coming up. Remember, my hips are coming out here and I can look up at that hand. And when you're ready, coming back down. My cat's gonna say hi. She wants to jump on there. All right. So let's do the other side now, okay? So I'm sitting here. I'm coming up on my hips. And I'm going to take this hand, and I'm going to reach it back to my ankle. And this top hand's going to come up. And I can look up, or if you want more bend, you can even look back farther. Breathing. And when you're ready, we'll come back up and sit. All right, we're ready to put both hands on the ground this time. So you can do one at a time or you can do them both at the same time. I'm gonna show you one at a time. So I'm gonna take this same hand and I'm gonna reach it back. And now I'm gonna take this hand and I'm gonna see if I can press back and reach towards my opposite ankle. So my thumbs are facing out and that helps roll my shoulders back and I'm looking up. My hips are pressing out. And then when you're ready, coming back up and sitting. So that is Camel Pose. And if you want to add a little more to that as well, let's see, what can I use? I'm gonna use a prop. You can take maybe a pillow or a stack of pillows, and I'm gonna place it behind my head. I'll show you. I'm gonna stack some pillows here. You might need a lot. All right, so I have all my pillows stacked. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna keep my hands together like this when I'm in my camel pose, but I'm gonna see if I can try to reach my head back and touch the pillows behind me. I remember I have to be really strong in my legs and press my hips out. So I'm gonna start the same, sitting up. My hands are coming to my heart. And I'm gonna start to press my hips away. And as I press my hips away, I'm gonna let my head drop. And maybe, I might not touch, but I'm aiming to go to these pillows. So here I go, pressing out, keeping my hips up and bending. Where are those pillows? There they are. And then come back up. And you can make it a game too. So if you touch the pillows and you feel like you can go even farther, then you can remove a pillow. And that's gonna help me bend a little bit more. So moving slow, I'm gonna try again. I got rid of one pillow. This is pretty low though. All right, so I'm gonna bring hands to my heart, hips coming out, reaching back. And I touch. And back down. So you can make a game out of it. So I got two pillows. I'm down to the last two. I'm gonna do this again, and we'll see how far I get. I'm gonna bring my hands to my heart, hips pressing out, and then reaching back. And I touch and come back down. One more. I think I can do it. I'm not sure. Let's try it. Comes my cat again. This is a really low pillow. All right, ready? Oops, she's gonna come sit. See if she stays there. Maybe I can tap her. All right, hands to my heart, hips coming out, bending back. And up. Whew, that was tricky. All right, so you can play with that. You can stack a lot of pillows and then maybe remove one at a time. Or you can bring your hands to your ankle and do it this way with your head coming back. Just remember to keep your hips coming out, and you want your legs to be really nice and strong as you push away. Okay, so let's end practice with some breathing. I'll put the music back on. And instead of lion's breath this time, we're gonna do a little meditation, so we're gonna sit nice and still. All right, I'm gonna sit back here. I'm gonna sit on my ankles this time because it feels comfortable today. And if you want, if you have pillows at home or blankets, you can also always sit on a pillow and give yourself a little more cushion, and it's a little cozier. So I'm gonna do that. Okay, so let's sit up or lie down, whatever you wanna do. And remember, I'm bringing one hand to my heart, one to my belly. And I'm gonna close my eyes. And I'm breathing in through my nose and out through my nose. I'm trying to stay still. Still that you are, the more you can feel your breathing coming inside your body and coming back out. And when you're ready, you can move your hands back to your lap and then open your eyes. And there you have it. So I hope everyone has a great weekend. And if you want to work on some of your new yoga poses, you can do your cat and cows or bridge or camel. And you can bring your hands to your ankles in camel, or you can use pillows if you have them. So you can play around with it. And I will see you all next Wednesday at 11:30. Bye, everyone.